In August of 1990, the United States committed more than 300,000 soldiers, sailors, airmen, and Marines to stop the aggression of a dictator and his million-man army. In January of 1991, the war of words escalated into a short, decisive, but costly war. This victory was won through the individual efforts of men and women from all across America. In support of this unified effort, the men and women of the United States Coast Guard were there. This is their story. As part of Operations Desert Shield and Desert Storm, the Coast Guard assumed three primary missions: port security and harbor defense in the theater of operation. Coast Guard boarding teams worked with the Navy as part of the Maritime Interception Force, enforcing United Nations sanctions against Iraq. And in the United States, the Coast Guard maintained security zones in ports to protect munitions, equipment, and supply ships. They also supervise the loading of explosives and hazardous materials. Once the President authorized the use of troops during the Gulf crisis, the Coast Guard rapidly dispatched trained port security men to supervise the dangerous job of loading explosives bound for the Middle East. This critical assignment was necessary to ensure the safety of personnel and property. Another important function the Coast Guard assumed was setting and maintaining security zones in ports and harbors where U.S. supply ships were being loaded for the Gulf. This job was underscored by the threat of terrorism, which potentially could have had a devastating effect on the loadout operation. And finally, Coast Guardsmen were on hand to supervise the actual loadouts themselves. Coast Guard vessel inspectors and marine safety personnel inspected each vessel bound for the Gulf.
Basically, what I'm concerned about is making sure that the longshoremen have done their job. So as I walk around the vessel, I'll check and make sure that these cribbing, these 3x6s, have been securely fastened by the longshoremen. So we can see that these particular items have been. The 2x12s that we see on the deck are designed specifically to help distribute the payload of the cargo unit so it doesn't stress out any one particular point on the decking.
In the early days of the Persian Gulf crisis, the United Nations Security Council called for sanctions against Iraq, including an embargo on all shipping. The President authorized U.S. forces to participate in a multinational maritime interception force to intercept ships in the Persian Gulf region. To support this interdiction effort, the Coast Guard committed boarding teams to embark on naval vessels to conduct boardings on merchant ships. They also utilized their experience in maritime law enforcement to train members of the multinational force in carrying out their mission.
Basically, what we do is we go over in a small boat with a Navy boarding team, a total of 10 people generally, four coasties and six Navy men. We go through all the cabins, all the storerooms, all the man-sized spaces. Then we go to the cargo holds, we inspect the cargo holds. If there's cargo on board, we'll inspect the cargo.
The Coast Guard boarded hundreds of vessels, successfully preventing many tons of war materials and supplies from reaching Iraq. The hazards of this job were many. There were long hours, endless days in which boarding teams traveled in rough seas, often at night, with the danger of boarding an unknown vessel carrying a potentially hostile crew.
The lead nets have performed marvelously. Much of the success that we've achieved here has been through their expert guidance and training that they provided to the Navy team.
The third Coast Guard mission involved the deployment of port security units from the Coast Guard Reserve. Their job was to ensure the safety of supply ship transit and cargo handling in theater, as well as to stop any attempt to disrupt the flow of materiel by terrorist act or any other hostile enemy action.
What we're mostly looking for is anything that would look out of the ordinary from an undercarriage. Any extra wires that generally wouldn't be there. Strange boxes that you know would not generally be under there. We were told to look for possibly boxes that might even be painted with undercoating, but so we're trying to make sure that there's nothing out of the ordinary there.
To carry out their harbor patrols, the PSUs utilized a heavily armed 22-foot boat specially developed for the Coast Guard's port security duties. Fast, maneuverable, and hard to detect on radar, the raider and its boat crews carried out their mission around the clock and helped make sure millions of tons of shipping reached the troops in the desert and the airmen above.
The demands, both physically and emotionally, are great, but this unit has accepted those demands, has accepted it as a challenge, performed very, very well under strenuous circumstances. So I would say overall, this unit has represented the Coast Guard and represented our country extremely well.
The men and women perform their mission under difficult conditions. The daily threat of SCUD missile attack, the dangers of boarding unknown vessels in a war zone, the likelihood of terrorist attacks, all were realities in the lives of these port security teams.
When all of a sudden I looked up into the sky and there was this red streak like a shooting star going across, I realized it was a Scud missile. It was quite a sight. And all of a sudden, then there was an explosion. The thing burst apart and it started to come down. I happened to be, say, about 500 feet away from this. And it was very exciting and very scary at the time.
Any extra wires that generally wouldn't be there. Strange boxes that you know would not generally be under there. We were told to look for possibly boxes that might